Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode should be the final video before the Demo 2 mission, so we'll start with that. Then we have Starship updates with SN4, SN5, SN6 and SN7, so lots of Starships today. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Beginning with Demo 2, where SpaceX recently tweeted a cool video to commemorate the launch pad. Obviously, LC-39A is one of the most historic launch pads, and so SpaceX tweeted the caption, Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon will lift off from Launch Complex 39A, the same place Saturn V launched humanity to the moon and from where the first and final space shuttle missions lifted off. NASA have also tweeted, NASA and SpaceX officials have given the go for the launch on a mission that will return human spaceflight to the US. There was also a series of tweets from Irene Klotz, an editor for Aviation Week. There was recently an interview with Elon Musk in which Musk explained the biggest risk. He said, "The part that I would worry most about would be re-entry, which won't happen hopefully for a few months from now. With Dragon 1, we have a simple conic on the leeward side, essentially the back shell of the spacecraft, so it's really quite symmetrical with no particular protuberances or anything. Whereas with Crew Dragon, because we have the escape thrusters side-mounted into the back shell, that creates an asymmetry. If you rotate too much, then you could potentially catch the plasma in the Super Draco escape thruster pods and could potentially cause either control disturbance or potentially overheat things. We've looked at this six ways to Sunday, so it's not that I think this will fail. It's just that I worry that it's a bit asymmetric on the back shell and so you could have a strange sort of roll coupling as you come in if you turn too much. I think this is low risk, but that's what I'd put as my biggest concern. I have been reading that there could be bad weather which may postpone the launch. SpaceX themselves tweeted yesterday that the weather was only 60% favourable. However, if everything goes to plan, this vehicle should lift off today at 8:33pm UTC or 4:33pm EDT. Over to Boca Chica now, where engineers have been doing further work on Starhopper. Apparently, what they've installed on the top here is a marine radar. Also, they appear to have installed something else onto a pole with other equipment such as cameras. In the construction yard, a few things were spotted, including this new roll of stainless steel. This is 304L stainless steel and is used for very specific parts of the rocket. Back in March, Elon Musk was asked about the new 301 stainless steel switch. Musk responded to say, some parts we use 304L as it has higher toughness at cryo temps, will move to internally developed alloys probably at the end of year. When Musk said internally developed alloys probably by the end of the year, he's not referring to this, I don't believe. Apparently, 304L is a commonly used stainless steel, but I'm no expert. Also, over by the new ring fabrication building, there is a new tent going up. I don't remember seeing this tent before, but here's the latest view of its construction. Moving on to SN4, which is continuing to be prepared. Last episode, I talked about a possible hop soon, but turns out I was wrong. From the same Aviation Week interview, Musk mentioned that the priority is Demo 2. He said, I have redirected SpaceX priorities to be focused on the crew launch. Going on to say, as a rough guess, I think we are a few weeks away from a hop. So it looks like we're going to have to wait before we get to see this machine fly. However, here is a great shot by Mary of the engine wrapped to SN20, which should perform the hop. Also spotted by SN4 is this interestingly welded block of steel. Whilst I have no idea what this may be for, I have read many suggestions as to its purpose. It was also connected to this interesting metal box. So, some have suggested maybe it's a counterweight to the offset thrust that will be produced by the engine. Others have said maybe it's to simulate the weight of the upper rings and nose cone. Finally on SN4, let's take a look at the TPS tiles where we saw last episode that one had gone missing. This looks to me to be the stud welded approach to attaching them. In my personal, potentially inaccurate opinion, maybe stud welding is not the best. I mean, if the tiles are falling off without the vehicle even moving, seems like another attachment method would be better. Now let's take a look at SN5, SN6 and even SN7. Yep, that's right, SpaceX now have four prototypes which have sections. There's really not much new stuff to look at, but here's the latest view of SN5 in the high bay. You can also see the SN5 nose cone ring stack was still sitting there. Until this happened, where this ring stack just decided it wanted to actually be a nose cone instead of a nose cone ring stack. This was apparently caused by the wind, and so you can see the need for the high bay. SpaceX then used a crane to pretty much turn it back into a ring. maybe they're going to just try and buff out the bends. You can see here that they are still working on the nose cone and have polished it further. For SN6, as we saw last episode, the ring stack for the tank is still sitting beside SN5 in the high bay. Then the lower bulkhead for the thrust section was also recently moved outside for sleeving with rings. As expected, the ring stack was then sleeved with the bulkhead to create part of the SN6 thrust section. Then finally, the newest member of the family has been spotted, SN7. Still in the early stages, it's crazy to see a stacked ring section for yet another starship. It was somewhat expected with the SN4 delays, but looks like SpaceX could need to expand their facility even more soon. As always, an enormous thank you goes to Mary BocaChica Girl for the amazing footage and to NASA Spaceflight for sharing it. Also, I want to thank S Padre for their great shots and live streams of the area. You are all doing amazing and greatly appreciated work. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.